Crime Stoppers has been highly successful in the United States. In New York, the scheme helped solve 15 murders in 1 month recently. And one police chief has described it as the most effective aid to the police to come in since the Second World War. But there are doubts as to whether it could be transferred successfully to London. It works like this. An informant with information contacts the police and is given a secret identification number. If the tip-off leads to an arrest, an independent civilian board decides on the reward and hands it over to the anonymous criminal, with the police not knowing where or when. The money would come from a fund raised by donations from large businesses. But despite Sir Kenneth Newman's enthusiasm for the scheme, the Coppers Union, the Police Federation, has its doubts.
I am very worried that it's another aspect of Americanization of the Metropolitan Police, and it does nothing to bring the police and the community closer together. It's almost an anonymous scheme, and we would prefer that such resources are channeled into manpower, because we maintain all along that the only time you're ever going to get the communities and police closer together is an increase in manpower. We are Americanizing the Metropolitan Police to such an extent that I'm very fearful for the future.
Scotland Yard quote the example of the murder of PC Keith Blakelock. They say witnesses were reluctant to come forward. But some politicians are not convinced more witnesses will respond.
People will come forward anyway if they have confidence in the police, and that's an important aspect of the argument. I think most people are willing to give information, but it's no good if they're not prepared to go to court to be a witness.
Scotland Yard's policy committee has considered a report from officers who've been to the United States to study Crime Stoppers American style. A decision won't be taken for at least 3 months, but it seems likely that the scheme will be enforced by the end of this year. This is Ken Andrew at Scotland Yard for Thames News.